this lecture we are going to discuss about problem on Porter governor. For a given problem, first we need to draw two free body diagram. With the help of this two free body diagram, we need to find the Q value. Not only Q value, we have to find out Q, H1 and H2. H means height of the governor. H1 means height of the governor at minimum speed. H2 means height of the governor at maximum speed. Then using H1 and H2, we have to find out N1 and N2. So N1 represent minimum speed of the governor, N2 represent maximum speed of the governor. Then finally, we have to find out the range of governor for this condition. So this is subdivision 1. Whereas in subdivision 2, we have to find out the minimum speed of the governor by considering the effect of friction. The frictional force acting on the governor will be given. So we need to find out N1F and N2F. Then by using N1F and N2F, we have to find the range of speed by considering the effect of friction. Let us see one by one. The arms of the Porter governor are each 250 mm long. Each means both upper and lower arm are equal in value. So that is 0.25 meter. Again, this is Porter governor, not Proyel. So whenever you read the problem, read carefully and understand whether it is Porter or Proyel. So this is Porter. Then each arm 250 mm long, which means both upper and lower arm are 0.25 meter, then pivoted on governor axis. So this is very, very important. Pivoted on governor axis. This is governor axis, and we have a point P somewhere here. So when these two conditions are satisfied, each arm are equal in length, then pivoted on axis of rotation means Q equal to 1, which means both upper triangle and lower triangle are symmetric, equal in shapes. See here, 250, 150, H2. Again, 250, 150, H2. When these conditions are satisfied, you will get Q equal to 1. So this is very, very important parameter. Then the remaining parameters are, the mass of the each ball is 5 kg, that is small m 5 kg, and the mass of the center sleeve is 30 kg. The radius of rotation of ball is 150 mm. So here we have 150 mm, R1. When the sleeve begin to rise, so this is H1, not H2. So this is H1. And it reach a value of 200 for maximum speed, which means we need to draw one more diagram. So this is a diagram for minimum position, and this is a diagram for maximum position. For maximum position, here you will get 200. So now our aim is to determine the speed range of the governor. So we need to find out N1, minimum speed of the governor, N2, maximum speed of the governor. From these two parameters, then we have to find out del N. So del N means range of governor. So apart from that, we need to find one more parameter. If the friction at the sleeve is equal to 20 Newton. So the first case, N1, N2 and del N are considered without considering the effect of friction. Actually, there is a dead weight somewhere here. So that dead weight creates some friction because that dead weight slide along this vertical axis. So because of that dead weight, there must be a friction. If that friction is 20 Newton, then again we need to calculate N1F, N2F, then again we have to find del NF. At last, we have to determine the range of speed by considering the effect of friction. So these are the parameter we have to find out for the given problem. Let us take free body diagram 1, that is minimum position. This is H1. I hope you know how to draw this diagram. First, you draw a vertical line, then add upper and lower arm. The problem itself given, both upper and lower arm are 250 mm, pivoted on axis of rotation. Then the radius of rotation for minimum position is 150. So all are given data. Here it is mg. small m, whereas here it is capital M. So capital M means mg by 2. So this should be divided by 2 because we are drawing only one side. So that is another side. So we are taking n by 2. So first we need to find out h1. So what is the formula for h1? Here h1 equal to, we need to apply Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse value minus this value. So h1, actually the formula is 250 squared equal to h1 squared plus 150 squared. Let me convert this centimeter mm value into meter and then rearrange this term. You will get h1 equal to square root of 0.25 squared minus 0.15 squared. So you will get 0.2 meter. So that 0.2 meter is nothing but height of the governor for minimum position. So q equal to 1. So we can take this formula, n1 equal to, so this is a standard formula for q equal to 1, small m plus capital M divided by m, small m into 895 divided by h1, small m value 5, capital M value 30, then again small m 5 multiplied by 895 divided by 0.2. So you will get this value. So this is n1 squared, so but we need n1. So when you take square root for this value, you will get 177 RPM. So this is the minimum speed of the governor. So we are calculating this value using this free body diagram. Next, I'm going to draw the second free body diagram, that is maximum position. Here you have H2. So follow the same procedure to draw the free body diagram for maximum position. Again, here apply the same formula. Instead of h1, here we are calculating h2. H2 equal to square root of 0.25 squared minus 0.2 squared. This is 200 mm, whereas here it is meter. So you will get 0.15 meter. So that 0.15 meter is nothing but height of the governor for maximum position. Again, apply this value on standard formula. Here also q equal to 1. So why q equal to 1? Because symmetric in shape, both triangle are symmetric in shape. Here 250, here also you have 250. So this 200 is common for both. So this should be a symmetric triangle. If q value not equal to 1 means, then there is an unsymmetric triangle in this diagram. So the formula m plus m divided by m multiplied by 895 divided by h2. So you will get this value. When you take square root for this value, you will get n2. N2 equal to 204.4 RPM. So now we have n1 and n2. So we can find out range of speed, del n. So del n equal to n2 minus n1, 204.4 RPM minus 177 RPM. You will get 27.4 RPM. So this is the value of range of speed without considering the effect of friction. So far we are not considering the effect of friction acting on dead weight. So Porter governor means there is a dead weight here. So that mg by 2 represent the dead weight. So this is the answer for subdivision 1. Next we are moving to subdivision 2. In subdivision 2, we need to consider the effect of friction. So while considering the effect of friction, h1, h2 values are same. So there is no need to calculate h1 and h2 value again. So only thing we have to consider the effect of friction. So this is a formula by considering the effect of friction. We have already discussed this in the derivation of Porter governor. N1 squared equal to mg plus mg minus f divided by mg into 895 divided by h1. So this is a formula for minimum speed of the governor. So minimum speed means the friction act against speed. That's why we are using minus sign. Sometimes what you do, you will use plus sign. You should not use plus. This is minus for n1. Whenever speed decrease because of the negative effect of force, that's why we have to use minus f. Then we are adding g because in the previous slide formula is m plus m divided by m. But in that formula, we are adding F. So F force, M mass. So either we need to consider force in, convert force into mass or mass into force. So we are considering, we are converting mass into force. So M multiplied by G, you will get force. So again G and G, you will get, this is unit of Newton, Newton, Newton. So there is no problem. If you use only M alone, then this is kg and this is Newton. So you cannot subtract kg with Newton. That's why we are using g, extra g. Mg plus mg minus, this should be minus. For minimum speed, speed will decrease. N1 means minimum because of negative effect of force. Now apply all the parameters. 5 into 9.81 plus multiplied by capital M value into 9.81 minus 20. That 20 value is given in the problem. Divided by 5 into 9.81 multiplied by 895 divided by 0.2. So 0.2 is nothing but minimum position, height of the height of the governor at minimum position. So you will get 29,500 from that N1 equal to 172 RPM. The same method you can calculate. So there is no need to draw a free body diagram to calculate N1F. That F means minimum position as a minimum speed of the governor by considering the effect of friction. Next, we need to calculate N2. While calculating N2, same formula, the only difference, this is plus. You will get maximum speed because of the addition of force. So when this value plus, you will get higher value of N. If it is minus, you will get lower value of speed. So NF2 square equal to, instead of H1, here you have to apply H2. So only two difference, minus plus H1 and H2. So apply all those parameters similar to N1F and you will get 44,200. When you take square root for this, you will get N2F equal to 210 RPM. Now subtract both these value. This is N2F minus N1F. This is del NF. So this is also F and this is also F. So you will get 38 RPM. So 38 RPM is the range of speed of governor by considering the effect of friction. So this is how you have to solve this problem. So I just want to tell only one more thing. So while solving this problem in the examination, you will make this mistakes, that plus minus. Instead of minus, you may put plus here, whereas here instead of plus, you will put minus. So what will happen when you do like this? Here you will get maximum speed, here you will get minimum speed. But N1 means minimum speed, N2 means maximum speed. So please remember this sign carefully. You are getting minimum value because of the, when you subtract force with a formula, you are getting maximum value because you are adding the term force with the remaining term. So this is the only thing you have to remember. Don't forget to post your questions in the comment box. You can also mention the topics which you expect from my channel. Subscribe my channel and like my video to support my video lecture.